only through conscious union with the individual, for this is the only possible solution of the great problem. How can the universal mind act in all its fullness upon the plane of the individual and particular? This is the ultimate of evolution, and the successful evolution of the individual depends on his recognizing this ultimate and working towards it. And therefore, this should be the great end of our studies. There is a correspondence in the constitution of the body to the faculties of the soul, and there is a similar correspondence in the faculties of the soul to the power of the all-originating spirit, as in all other adaptations of specific vehicles, so also here. We can never correctly understand the nature of the vehicle and use it rightly until we realize the nature of the power for the working of which it is specially adapted. Let us then, in conclusion, briefly consider the nature of that power. Chapter 16. The Spirit. What must the supreme, all-originating spirit be in itself? That is the question before us. Let us start with one fact regarding it, about which we cannot have any possible doubt. It is creative. If it were not creative, nothing could come into existence. Therefore, we know that its purpose or law of tendency must be to bring individual lives into existence and to surround them with a suitable environment. Now, a power which has this for its inherent nature must be a kindly power,